What we're hearing right now, Kyle, is that you're the winner of the race.
Pennies for the third time breaks the bank at Rockingham. And 1992 becomes the first year that Kyle Petty notches two wins in the record book in a single season.
He takes the checkered flag and wins the Champion Spark Plug 500.
Kyle Petty wins it.
I've been very fortunate to have some great car owners through the years.
Turn three head-on, barrel rolled several times, and eventually caught fire, winding up on its roof in turn four.
Loved what he did to be a race car driver at this level.
Death was painless and instantaneous.
Love, son, brother, and friend.
He's going to get the win of the UNWGM Quality 500. Jason Leffler with his first butt pole in just his 28th try. Leffler with point leader Jeff Gordon on the front row.
Sterling Moll has jumped out of his car. He's going around to look at the right front fender. But, he can't do that.
Marlin wins the Carolina Dodge Dealers 400. Sterling Marlin brings the Coors Light Dodge across the line.
Hard into the wall. Sterling Marlin, a vicious crash.
Special of the year.
And tonight it is the rookie Jamie McMurray. Go ahead, caller, you're on the air.
Jamie, way to go, man.
Holy cow, can you believe this?
May we never ever shed another tear.
Peddler big, here comes the nine car.
One top five, five top
ten. Oh,
gambled and lost.
Of talent, Dario Franchitti. I'm excited about the kind of future he's going to have here in a stock car.
16th career start is here in NASCAR as the pole sitter.
I'm Pablo Montoya making his first NASCAR start here in the Busch Series.
Open Wheel Series champion in 99, the Indy 500 winner.
Final turn. The fuel lives and Montoya wins at Sonoma.
About 10 seconds of field.
Well, there was enough to go to the last pace lap, I guess, after the checker. He made that, so, I mean...
For Montoya, it was his first Cup win in just his 17th Cup race.
But these clouds, they won't go away. Problems?
And a look at the newly merged Earnhardt Ganassi Racing Team. The two teams to put together a merger, Ganassi's side of the team should be more competitive, moving from Dodge to Chevrolet. But overall, the new Earnhardt Ganassi Racing organization will face a challenging 2009.
Checkered flag in the air, the 52nd Daytona 500.
As he becomes our 10th, trouble right at the pin end.
Yeah!
Jamie McMurray is going to win Daytona and the Brickyard 400 in the same year.
Nancy Rick, guys, unbelievable.
Chip, I know you normally you don't get very emotional, but what a special day for you and this entire organization.
Pretty special. You know, my heart goes out to Juan. He had a great day too, but he and Jamie, you know, fast target. This is for all of them.
Jamie McMurray's your winner. Jamie's sixth career win.
They were so disappointed that they did not make the chase. They felt they were a chase caliber team.
And where this organization was a year ago and how far we've come.
Way to go there, big boy. Good job.
And now, under caution, Juan Pablo Montoya has crashed and the car brakes won't steer, and he slides up the track and into the back of that surplus helicopter jet engine.
Oh my gosh.
Montoya stepped it up. He was a 10th quicker than Harvick this lap.
Yeah, that big car in Montoya. I'm
don't think Kevin can get there. I did for a while, but I don't think he can make it now. That was not what Montoya wanted to see.
Jamie McMurray wins at Talladega.
My name is John Olguin. As most of you know, I'm the head of communications at Earnhardt Ganassi Racing with Felix Sabatis, 2014 driver of the number 42 Target Chevrolet.
We believe that Kyle's the future of the sport.
The age of five, Kyle Larson has only wanted to be a race car driver. And now, as he comes to the checkered flag, Kyle Larson's going to win in the Sprint Cup Series.
California kid, Kyle Larson brings it off turn number four. He, Chip Ganassi, and Chevrolet are going to victory lane at Fontana.
Chip Ganassi Racing, a hug from the boss.
Car 42, Kyle Larson, number one at Michigan International Speedway.
Kyle Larson coming to the line with Truex chasing, will win his third time in a row here in Michigan.
Kyle Larson wins at Richmond.
There's a new number one in town, and I'm taking her to Daytona.
Kurt Busch moving to Chip Ganassi Racing from...
Kurt Busch will win!
Hell yeah! Hell yeah!
To win the open to transfer, he did. And now Kyle Larson wins $1 million.
Kyle, it's been a long time for you to get to victory lane. It's been a tough year.
Kyle Larson, who's going to give Chip Ganassi Racing their first run into the next round, the furthest they've ever gone. Larson wins at the Monster Mile.
And used a racial slur language has shocked the NASCAR community.
I'm sorry.
Chip Ganassi Racing, his team has suspended him without pay, ordered Larson to complete a sensitivity course before he's eligible for reinstatement.
One of Wisconsin's top sports stars, Matt Kenseth, is coming out of retirement.
I qualified good tonight. I'm backed up a little bit. I'm kind of just hanging out at the moment. Certainly made my share of mistakes in 2.5 races or 2.5.
Race leader, 42, Matt Kenseth.
Now it's Kenseth, running second, trying to get a draft.
Great run for this guy.
Yeah, Matt Kenseth in that 42.
I'm just gonna quite get it done.
Kurt Busch, the 2004 Cup champion, is gonna win in his hometown. Busch wins in Vegas. So it won't be the same for the Las Vegas native, but still being able to win.
Moving on to the next round.
If only there was a crowd here to roar for it.
42 at Chip Ganassi Racing. That seat was filled today by Ross Chastain.
I'm looking for big things out of him with this 42 car and Chip Ganassi Racing this year.
And white checkers. And Ross Chastain is an all-star.
As you see up here with me, I have the CEO of Chip Ganassi Racing, Chip Ganassi. But we're here to announce that Trackhouse Entertainment Group, Trackhouse Racing, has purchased the NASCAR operation of Chip Ganassi Racing. Trackhouse has acquired all of the NASCAR assets of Ganassi Racing, including all the equipment and its components. Trackhouse will take ownership of the assets at the conclusion of the 2021 racing season.
I must say our team was not for sale. Justin simply came to me with a great offer and even a better vision. I actually owe a lot of thanks to some of the NASCAR leadership. I felt they've been some of my greatest mentors. People like Jim Trans, Bill Trans Jr., Mike Helton, and some of these people are becoming even better friends than I am.
Shed another tear for today. 'Cause oh, I know that there'll be better days.